Hi, I'm Doug from Office. I want to show you some more tips about using the Morph Transition in PowerPoint, a new transition for Macs, PCs, iPads, and other devices. They're a little more advanced, but I still think this is easier than breaking open the Animations tab and doing all of those things. Morph does a lot of the heavy lifting for you. I also like this because I'm going to show you some tools you can use when designing and redesigning slides that are good shortcuts, good ways to design better slides more quickly. So these movements are made just using the Morph transition. Pretty cool. Let's dig in the deck and I'll show you how it's done. At first sight, the difference between slide 2 of the planets and slide 3 of Mars doesn't seem like it's a transition. I'm going down here to the zoom tool and back off the slide a bit. Look at what's happening. There's elements off the slide. All the planets are here, they're just off to the right where we don't see them on the slide when it's presented. Let me move the space background to show you this white rectangle. That's the slide area that we see. So you don't need to precisely crop everything to the slide size. It's okay to have things over the slide if parts don't need to be seen. Another tool is the Selection Pane. Alt F10 is the keyboard shortcut. This lists all the elements on the slide, mainly a lot of pictures here. As you click each line, the element is selected on the slide. You can hide all the elements or select certain ones that you want to work on. Let's dig into Jupiter here, which is off the slide. I'll show all the elements, then turn off picture 22, turn off Jupiter. See, all the text about Jupiter that's going to be used on the next slide is behind the picture. I'll click a bit of text and turn them off with the selection pane by selecting this eye icon. You can also title each of the elements to find them quickly. So let's show you how I would build the Mars slide. I would duplicate the planet slide and then take off all the elements I don't want, including the title, the satellite, and the text. I'll zoom out and select the rest of the planets by holding down the Control key and selecting each one. This way I can move them and keep the spacing the same. As I do all these things, you'll see red lines appear. These guidelines help keep elements in line, proportionally correct, and centered. Let me zoom back in. Enlarge Mars. And move the text around to where I want them to appear. As I move things around, the guidelines help me find the right spaces. I can fine-tune this later, but let's preview the transition to see Morph in action.